Sydney's Western Fringe is a picturesque doggy sanctuary.
Welcome to the Animal Welfare League.
I'm keen to get a dog.
You're in the right place.
We're dedicated staff.
I think we're going to find you a home.
Pair the orphaned and abandoned with hopeful new owners.
Oh my gosh.
To see if lives can be changed by the perfect match.
Doggy time. Are you nervous?
Yeah.
I'm nervous about what we're gonna put it in terms of clothes, because it's gonna match us, right?
We're gonna have to get custom made turtlenecks.
BFFs Erica and Sarah want to find a high class pooch for their cosmopolitan lifestyle.
We met in high school in our first year, and we bonded over a teacher not liking us.
Hello.
Hi.
Welcome to the Animal Welfare League.
Thank you.
Sisters?
No.
No. We've been friends for 15 years. And now we have decided that we're going to get a dog.
People always assume that we're together. No, we're not dating. We're just really, really close friends.
It's like having a friend as a soulmate. You find someone that is on the same wavelength as you, and it's just so easy with us.
It's gonna be a cool dog.
A cool
hip happening dog. Yeah. Any little outfits? Any cute outfits on the agenda for the doggy?
So many.
A lot.
Our dog's gonna have some sequins, turtlenecks,
crocs.
Yeah, leopard print.
Yeah, cowboy hat.
For sure.
Yeah,
no doubt.
What do you reckon you'd be if you're an animal court?
Chihuahua.
Yeah.
Yeah.
When someone runs at you, run off.
No, that's not.
You are.
No, would not be. What would Sam be?
A border collie for sure. It's hairy. Yeah, great.
Can get on the chubby side.
Working here definitely requires a certain type of personality.
That was a bit cute, isn't it?
Yeah, everyone has their own little quirks.
Oh.
Yeah, Nicola. Very outgoing and spontaneous, and just says what she wants to say, which is great. Hello, are you okay?
Oh, look, you decided to do some work.
Well, who's dirty? Not you.
I like to think of myself as a bit of a mother hen.
Juliet, she's often seen in tears, whether it be happy tears or sad tears.
Yeah, I like to show my prior.
Who's a good boy? Hey, you're a good boy. A few of the staff call me the dog whisperer.
I have this feeling he rolls in mincemeat before he comes to work.
Look, I do think secretly the beard has a lot of secret power in it. Yeah, a lot of dogs chew on my beard. I don't know, maybe I've got some food left over.
Taylor is amazing at her behaviour knowledge.
I sort of can read a dog and how they're feeling, perhaps before other people might be able to see that. If I was to summarise Oreo in one sentence, it would be a bit anxious, but a lot of potential. Very good.
Everyone who ends up working here is a really passionate personality. It takes a really special person to be able to hang out with dogs all day and pick up poop every day.
Hi.
Hi.
How are we?
Good.
How are you
guys?
Good. I'm Taylor.
Hi.
Nick.
What can we do for you guys today?
We're hopeful to be getting an apartment-friendly dog. We both work partly from home, partly from the office well.
Yeah.
So a dog that could kind of take it easy either way.
And okay. What about age range?
It'd be ideal if we could have a good amount of years with the dog as well. So maybe not too elderly.
Given that something small would generally live 16 to 17 years.
Yeah.
I'd say 8+ is probably too old.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Do you agree?
I was going to say 10, but yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. And what does your ideal dog look like?
We really like Chihuahuas.
All right.
Why Chihuahuas of all breeds?
We love funny dogs. And the whole, not that we want to put it in a handbag, but
if it fits,
Yeah, if the shoe fits, if the dog fits.
Exactly.
We've prematurely bought some stuff. We have a toy, we have a little bed, we got some treats. Yeah. So, we're really keen.
Yeah, committed. You thought of everything.
Outfits?
Yeah. We have one
jumper at the moment.
Yeah.
I knew it.
Yeah.
So their favorite breed is Chihuahua.
Actually, we have a Chihuahua, don't we?
We do have a Chihuahua, but the only one that would be suitable is Bonnie.
Bonnie, she goes in and she sits at the desk, and you quite often see typing with Bonnie just sitting between her. She just sits there, and people walk in and out. They're fluffy, friendly lady, pretty chill. She's quite relaxed, which is what they're after, you know. And I believe she came in through our inspectorate department.
Yes, correct. Yeah, but at the same time, they've already been surrendered to the woman who surrendered them again. So she's been through at least two separate homes.
So she's never had just like
this is potentially her third home in her life.
That's so sad. So she's
compromised somewhere.
Okay. The first dog I thought of was not Bonnie, I must say. I thought that Lulu might be a good fit. She's that size that they're after and the age that they're after. Yeah. So she's two. I love her.
She's a snossage.
She's so cute. And we never get dash hounds in, so it's quite
nice.
She's
a snossage.
She's got separation anxiety, which might not be an issue if she's taking the dog to work, because it's so hard to rehome Lulu because of her separation anxiety.
The issue is that her dog sociability is not best.
She's not dog social.
But Bonnie's a pretty social.
She is. She came in.
The other things they're asking for, she fits in quite well.
Absolutely.
She does.
Fingers crossed they compromise on the age.
I hope they'll be able to find something that matches us.
Yeah.
Trust the process.
Oh, yeah. The universe is going to provide.
It will.
We are manifesting as we speak.
Yeah.
This is...
The vibes are out.
Yeah.
All right, ladies. We've had a bit of a chat with our manager.
Okay.
And we think we might have found you the right friend.
Oh, my gosh.
She's a she. Fluffy.
Yes.
Gorgeous.
Sweet, cuddly.
Playful. Okay.
She's fine with being picked up. She's great with dogs.
Yes.
Great with handling.
Yeah, she is good with handling.
One thing, though, that we're going to have to compromise on, perhaps, is she is 9 years old.
Yeah. But since you guys are so good and you compromise on the age, you don't have to compromise on the breed.
Oh, my God.
Stop.
She is a Chihuahua. Little mixed Chihuahua.
Oh, my God.
We manifested it.
We did it.
Oh, my God.
The universe listened. We received.
So her name is Bonnie.
Oh my God.
It's happening.
Sarah is my best friend. Getting a dog is the natural next step. I actually can't believe it's happening. The fact that we live together already feels like it's too good to be true.
Here we go.
What? Bonnie?
I'm freaking out.
I definitely feel Erica will be a good dog mum. She has a lot of love to give. I definitely feel it as her friend.
I hope she likes us.
I know. I would not want to get a dog with anyone else. I know I can always depend on Sarah, no matter what.
The first day of the rest of our lives.
Yeah, I can't imagine being a co-parent with anyone else.
We're gonna meet her.
Bonnie
is a long-haired Chihuahua cross.
Let's go.
She's definitely a queen and she knows it. She just loves being with people. She's a little zippy little thing that loves to run around. Even being an older lady, that doesn't slow her down. She is a big favourite here just because she knows that she's deserving of an amazing life outside of the shelter.
I have to say, they're the real odd ducks of the dog world, Chihuahuas. They do some really bizarre things.
Yeah.
Having fostering one at the moment, you know, she's a real underpants thief. She steals them and then she does like a little dance around it and rolls in it. They can be really strange little monsters.
Look up here.
She's got that little poofy tail.
That's how I walk in heels.
Are you ready?
Yes. I was born ready.
Bonnie ready.
Ah!
Me and Eric have known each other for 15 years. Getting a dog is kind of like a... that people do in the next stage of their relationship.
I hope she likes us.
I know. It will complete our home. It's basically like starting a little family. Like, instead of a baby, we now have a dog that we have to take care of.
Oh my God.
Bonnie!
Come on, Bon Bon.
Thank you.
best friends, Sarah and Erica, are meeting Queen Bonnie for the first time.
Oh my god.
Probably get on your lap at some point.
Okay.
She'll provide the entertainment.
I'm fine.
Wow. Okay, that's a reaction and a half.
That's a nice reaction.
That is so nice.
I hope she comes to them.
I know. At the moment, she's got no interest in them, but if I was body size and somebody was squealing, I probably wouldn't either.
Hey, Bonnie, come here. Hi.
What'd you find there?
She's been quite independent, though. I did expect to see Bonnie at least wag her tail or be a little bit more sociable than she's being.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hello. W-L. Emma, what was your name?
Amrita.
Dog lover Amrita is hoping to find a new pup to shower with love.
I'm originally from India, moved to Australia in 2006.
I'm excited.
Yeah.
Hoping to meet my perfect dog.
My ex-husband was Australian and I found a job opportunity here in Sydney and that was the best decision.
You've got a lot of dogs here?
Oh, we have so many at the moment, all waiting for their homes. Waiting for homes like yours.
When I first see a dog, I see the eyes and then the ears. I like the floppy ears.
Crazy dog lady.
Yeah. And there's nothing wrong with that at all.
Oh, I love it. It's proud.
Hey, Bonnie. Bon.
Gosh.
Hey, Bonnie, do you like us?
I don't think she has decided yet.
I mean, it's pretty normal to sort of question whether or not the dog likes you, especially if it's ignoring you like this. But rescues, you gotta give him a second.
Hey, Bonnie.
That's okay, she'll come back. She's not ready yet.
She's not ever had a permanent home. It probably takes a while to build that bond with somebody.
Yeah, 100%.
Hey, Bonnie. Come here.
Look at this.
What's that? Come here. Hey.
Oh, hey.
She licked you.
Hey.
Yeah, what do you think?
Oh.
Hey. I think she likes you.
Hi.
Hello.
What about Sarah? What do you think?
What do you think about Sarah?
Yeah.
Hi.
Oh.
What's interesting about Bonnie is she doesn't give a lot off in her face.
It's
purely her body.
Yeah, I noticed that too.
Yeah.
Yes, that's right.
She could probably pick her up now if she wanted.
I think they're very comfortable.
Yeah, tail's still out. Go for it.
Oh.
Hi.
Oh, she licked.
That's perfect.
That's all we want to see. That's beautiful.
Okay.
We're going to take care of you.
Yeah.
Shelters don't always have chihuahuas, but we kept thinking about it, like manifesting it, saying we will get a chihuahua.
Manifested it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We've completed our whole, like, family.
Yeah. Oh my god.
How are we?
Not too bad.
That's good.
Tell us a bit about your
your dream dog?
I live in a tiny apartment close to the city, so a smaller size medium dog or a small to medium. I'm very social, and I would love to be able to take my dog with me.
Yeah.
He or she is dog friendly.
Yeah. Perfect, yeah. And I'm assuming the dog will be inside most of the time.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah?
I love that.
I'll be sleeping in my bedroom, for God's sake.
Oh, that's so cute.
Perfect.
Yeah, totally spoiled.
I don't think people choose dogs. I think it's the dogs that choose people.
And what kind of life will this dog have with you?
I live alone.
Okay.
So my dog is essentially going to be the center of my universe.
Oh, I love that.
They take you from the hardest parts of your life, carry you through. My dog Bailey passed away in November.
Oh,
so
sorry.
Yeah.
So we need a new friend.
Yes.
Yeah.
Bailey was my last dog. I had him for 10 years and he was my soul dog. I was having a tough time in my marriage and he was the only one who took me through it. He was a rescue from a pet store, but to be really honest, I didn't rescue him. He rescued me every day from
that. Oh, it's gonna make me cry.
So that's Bailey. I loved his flip-flop ears. I think we look alike. He takes after his mummy.
How's it going?
Absolutely lovely. Any animal that goes home to her is going to be spoiled, rotten.
Oh, really? Yes.
So, with size-wise, the first dog I think about is Coco. He is full of personality.
Little Coco. He's a cute little thing.
He is really full on. He's only young. He's only about 8 months old.
Okay.
He needs a lot of training. Yeah, I think he's very close, but he's probably not the one.
Does anyone else come to mind then that would be better suited?
I think Oreo might be a really good fit.
Oh, little Oreo.
He's a sweet little boy.
Yeah. He's so cute.
He is Jack Russell Cross, and he just loves to investigate life.
I love him. He's such a character.
Yeah, he's a sweet little boy.
She is, like, pretty ideal for him.
Oh, yeah. He'll bond so quickly to Amrita.
Yeah.
And I'm sure vice versa.
What do you think?
Oh, it's so lovely to watch them play.
It's a good time waster, hey?
Who needs an aquarium? Hello.
Hello. Oh. We think we have found you a good fit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
He's very friendly.
Super social.
You know, like he has to say hi to everyone. He's a moderately active sort of guy.
Yep.
He just needs some work learning, you know, hands are safe. And with handling and whatnot, he can be a bit shy. Mm-hmm. But he works up so quickly. And once he is good friends with you, he doesn't want to leave you alone. Such a lapdog.
Aww.
Yeah.
So his name is Oreo.
Oreo.
Yes. Cute little name.
Yeah. How are you feeling?
Oh, just excited to meet him.
Oh, good. And he's good. Probably just as excited as you too.
Excellent.
Perfect.
Okay. Let's start then.
Awesome.
Right, follow us.
I'm excited and also petrified all at the same time. Is he going to like me? Or come sniff, turn around and go back now. Sorry. Thanks.
Is a two-year-old Jack Russell Cross, who is a very affectionate and loving boy.
Boy.
He came to us through our inspectorate surrender, and he has become quite confident since he's been here.
Cool.
I think the ride home for Oreo would be someone that is home more often and can have him inside, because he likes to be more a part of the family than on his own, which helps him to build his confidence and get him used to what life is outside of the shelter.
I am very devoted to dogs. My ex-husband and I, we were doing the long-distance relationship for 2 years. We were married for 5.5 years, out of which we spent 3 years in marriage counseling. Then I went through divorce and restarting my career. And the moment Bailey came into my life, I felt like a whole person. After my divorce, Bailey, he was just times and whenever I needed him. He taught me love, what it feels like to love somebody and what it feels like to be loved.
Hello, it's Oreo. Are you happy for me to let him off lead?
Yeah.
He's a big investigator. So if he can have that chance, he's super happy about it.
I think if he just shows the gentleman he is, he'll be right. He's going to have a sniff around first.
Yeah, of course.
Only thing is, he can be a bit funny with handling, so he's probably not going to be, like,
super speechy. Yeah, not straight away.
I know she's going to be upset, yeah, obviously, from Bailey, but I hope that that doesn't get in the way of building a bond with Oreo.
Yeah.
Oreo. Come on, come here. The level of indifference.
Good boy. Good boy. Good boy.
So, like, he's come over to say hi and she's gone to pat him and he's immediately rolled into his back. So that's a submission thing, as we know. So ideally you'd want to pat and then stop.
And then stop.
And he'd probably try and get him back up.
Here, one more. On this side too. Oh my God, look at you. Getting all this fussy. Yes. Yes.
Oh,
stop touching. He's going to bite her.
Yeah, stop.
So let's go down, head on.
It's exciting to know what kind of dog we can meet.
I really want to go to New York.
Murphys want to fulfill 12-year-old Jasmine's dream by getting a dog.
I was like, can we get a dog? Can we get a dog? And she's like, no, no. And then a couple years later, she's like, oh, do you want to get a cat? And I'm like, no.
Hey, how you going?
Hello, welcome how are you?
Yeah, good. Welcome to AWL. Excited.
Oh, we're excited. Yes. We can't wait to meet our potential forever dog. Yes.
And who's going to be the one that makes the final decision, Mum, Dad, or Jasmine?
Ooh.
The best thing about my dad, he usually gets me whatever I want.
Daddy's wrapped around this little finger. Princess Jasmine always rules, doesn't she? Yes.
Yeah.
Sometimes the world revolves around Princess Jasmine. Doting dad, loving mum, Princess Jasmine. Yes.
So what dog do you think?
When you talk to people about the kind of dog that they're looking for, it comes down to two things every time: looks and personality.
Good boy.
If they've grown up around a certain type of dog, it tends to be what they kind of gravitate towards when they're an adult. You know, some of the stereotypes are things like small dogs are yappy. Working breeds are high energy and fiercely loyal.
The challenge that we often face here at AWL, though, is that the trauma and shelter life can really hide away some great little personalities.
When a dog gets a bit nippy or uncomfortable, how many people go, oh, that's hard?
I mean, this environment is just really hard for these dogs.
Yeah.
When we get dogs who come in who have been really neglected and really abused, and they just do not trust people. Hello, Oreo.
Hello.
Hi, Amrita. I don't always expect an instant connection, but I like to make sure the dog is comfortable around those people. Oreo, his background, we don't know the full history of his background.
All right.
Dogs like Oreo who do come through our shelter, they do tend to come with a bit of baggage, I guess is the best way to put it. So, which, you know, obviously watching before, that's, you know, he did have a little snap then.
Yes.
When you were patting him. When he does go on his back, when he submits,
yeah.
You'll notice his tail starts wagging, he goes really frozen.
Yeah.
That's when you probably just pull your hand away.
Yeah.
Yeah, he'll choose if he wants to come to you or not.
Yeah.
he needs to trust you. Once he trusts you, he'll be best mate. He'll be very loyal. The thing with Oreo to win, get to his heart is free treats and some toys as well. So what I'll do, if you're comfortable, I'll leave you in here, build a bit more of a bond, and then we'll go from there.
Fantastic.
Okay? You know, it's nice to see when that breakthrough does come through, especially for a timid dog who suddenly does turn around and go, oh, hang on a second, I'll be with you for 5 minutes. Actually, you know what? You're actually really nice now. And show that, it's really nice to see.
Thank you.
Okay, have fun.
Oh, well.
Good boy. You stay here.
Okay. At the moment, right now, I don't know. He's a lovely boy. Hopefully, once he gets a little bit of confidence back, then he might be the perfect boy. Down. Stay. Good boy. Stay. Nice. Did you have a good chat?
Yeah. I think Amrita's obviously...
He's learning.
Like, she's responding really cute. Well to her.
Yeah.
Nice. Drop. Good boy.
Nice, smart.
Very smart. Yeah, he's doing really well.
What she's doing is trying to get his trust. Something he really likes, which is food.
Yeah, like he doesn't like pets. Okay, we'll do something else then. How about we learn some tricks?
Do you want to play something?
Oreo.
Come it. Yeah.
How many people would have been like, nope, as soon as a dog would get a bit snappier on the
top? Yeah, it's like, great. He's playing now. He seems a lot more comfortable.
Oh, you like that one better? You like that one better?
Stark does not. Find the end. Stark can be rough.
Good boy.
I completely understand how he felt at that moment. It's scary.
Oh, hi.
She had mentioned that Bailey really saved her. I really hope that she sort of sees that Oreo's the one that needs a saving now.
Yeah.
And she's going to be the one saving Oreo.
Yeah.
Would you like to take him for a walk?
Yeah, that'd be great.
Awesome.
We're dogs. Learned one thing, you never know. If he wanted to bite me, he would have really bitten me. It was more of a warning that, hey, back off. I learned from that he will initially need a lot more space than I thought.
Oreo, come here. Oreo.
At the moment, he's anxious still. I mean, it is quite possible that he might not want to be with me.
Good boy. Good boy.
How are you guys?
Weird.
I'm Nick, this is him.
Hello.
Hi.
How can we help you today?
We would love to adopt a dog.
Yes.
Ooh. Yes. And Jasmine being the main instigator. Yes.
Brought your friend along with you.
Yeah, she brought her.
Buddy, my golden retriever, and I want him to have a brother or sister.
I see. Okay. What are you guys looking for?
We always had Weimaraners, so
right. Okay.
Quite so used to be active
dogs.
Yes. Yeah. And had two always together.
What kind of life picture are we looking at for this dog?
Boating. We love going on our boat.
Nice.
Camping. Motorbike riding.
We're pretty outdoorsy, you know.
It's the three of us, so we're together most of the time.
We mostly like to be outdoors. That's the main thing.
And your family are great. You love us.
Yeah, I do love them.
If it's two, my dad's face will be like...
So you guys are open to taking two if that was a possibility?
I always said if it was two that came in together and were already bonded,
and he's like,
I would take them both together, yes.
I prefer to have one.
I prefer to have two.
But that doesn't have any say.
Apparently.
You're not getting any of the dogs you want. It's all my dog. And if it's mum's, I'll be happy, but it's going to be a golden retriever.
They like big dogs.
It's good to hear.
Yeah, they like big dogs.
Big dogs.
People.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah.
So we do have Mila.
I love her so much.
She is amazing. She is so intelligent. She is
high energy.
She does have a little bit of separation anxiety, so she's quite vocal in the kennel.
Before we hear any further, I do have a suggestion that's a little out of left field. They said they'd take two, potentially.
They can take two?
They can.
Yeah, okay.
I was thinking Pip and Louis. I think they're perfect.
Pippi and Louis.
So, gorgeous Pippi. She is an amazing dog.
Beautiful.
She is
really sweet.
Red Kelpie. And she's 3 years old. She's dog social. She's people social. I mean, to me, she's an absolute no-brainer.
Yeah.
She's just... So she comes with gorgeous, gorgeous Louis. He's a border collie cross.
He's beautiful.
He's a stunning dog. So he's 1 year and 8 months.
Super active, so they'll be able to keep up.
They'll keep each other company while the kids are
I think Pippi and Louis is a really good choice.
Yeah.
Two medium-sized dogs who are quite bonded to be really happy together. It's a great opportunity to take.
Would you be okay if they did want to take just one?
Yeah. It'd be nice if they could take both.
So, guys, we're really excited.
Good. We're excited.
I think we've found something that's going to just absolutely blow you away.
I heard something, so that's one.
Not giving any away.
His name is Louis.
Oh.
He's a border collie cross kelpie.
Oh, wow. Now, I know he's not as big as what you were kind of hoping for, but I think... personality-wise and the lifestyle that you have, this dog is just going to fit in amazingly with your family.
Yes.
He does have a girlfriend.
Oh!
Yeah. So her name is Pippi.
He's very much in love.
Very in love.
Yes.
She is also a little kelpie, a little red kelpie.
Okay. And when you guys are at work, they're going to spend some
time there. Yes.
Okay. How do you feel?
All excited to meet them.
This is literally a one-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and this is going amazing.
Oh, yeah. And you haven't even met them yet.
It will be the most funnest life ever, and we will have the most adventures and stuff with this dog.
Oh, my God.
Double trouble. Really.
We're going to try and make this dog be the happiest it's ever going to be.
Oh, this is nice.
Oh my god.
Look how cool this is.
This is epic.
It makes your house feel full when you have a dog, you know? You come home and the dog always wags its tail. You had a bad day, the dog's wagging its tail, even though they've eaten the clothes off the line.
Two of the multiple dogs that we had come from a regional branch.
Let's go.
So this is Louis. He is super sweet. He is the more relaxed out of the two of them. This is Pippi, our Kelpie. She was previously on a farm being a working dog. So she's quite driven, quite athletic. However, she's really sweet. Together, it can be quite chaotic. Pippi is usually trying to bite Louis's legs, chasing after him. However, they are having a fun time.
Were these guys on death row, Sam?
Look, to be honest with you, all animals at the regional facilities, unless they are picked up in a certain time frame, they are on death row. Unfortunately, because they get so many come through the doors.
Really?
So I got a phone call from Oreo branch asking if we could help out with a few. And the ones we couldn't help out with would unfortunately go back. So obviously it'd be a bit soft hearted, and I said we'd take them all.
Yeah.
What a surprise!
You know, and I'm glad we did, because we get dogs like Pippi and Louis, who are absolutely gorgeous dogs. You know, they should have a second chance of life and find a great family.
Don't be
vegan. So they fall in love with both of them.
Yes. Come on, guys.
Oh my goodness.
They're very excited.
Oh my god.
Pippi and Louie.
So this is Pippi.
Hello, Pippi.
And then Emma's got Louie.
Hello, Louie.
Hi, Pippi.
My goodness.
Hello. How are you?
Oh, my
I told you they're going to just
come. Hi.
No, look how excited they are.
That's so cute.
Hi! Oh my god!
Well, look, your girlfriend.
Crazy! Alright,
we're gonna let them off. They might jump. Oh, that service okay. Too much.
We'll let them.
We definitely also want to have a run around.
Oops. Whoa, this is crazy!
Oh, here we go!
You do come up.
Oh dear.
I mean, Jasmine, I don't know whether she's really ever had dogs at this energy level because I think she was 8 when the other two passed.
Hello. Hi.
She wouldn't remember them as being young and active like this.
Yeah, of course.
Jasmine has no filter. Jasmine is Jasmine.
Hello.
No, don't go your face. She will be outspoken in a sense to say, this is me, this is who I am.
They're just excited for each other.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh.
She owns being an only child. She was destined to be an only child.
And mum got a best friend.
Yes. Yeah, she's definitely a character, and people have always said, why did you not have any more children? I said, because I have a Jasmine. Oh, straight in the water. I said to Jasmine, you know you're going to go gaga over whatever walks through that door.
Oh my goodness.
But if you don't at any stage feel that this is going to be the right dog for us, that I need you to say no.
Mum, they're too excited.
Come on. Wait till they... Oh, they're going to get jealous.
Hi.
Here, you want a treat?
Good girl.
And doesn't have to be the specific breed, but that specific temperament, I think, more so.
Yeah, the temperament more.
Yes.
Guys, come on.
Oh,
gentle, Jasmine.
But watch them when they get jealous of each other.
Oh, gosh.
Just hold it, don't linger around.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
That's okay.
I was too scared.
I think she's a bit nervous. I wonder if their family dogs ever had a fight.
I'm scared.
That's all right. No, they're all right.
They're too excited.
I've got two Kelpies. One of them, when he picks up a rope toy, he's like,
yeah,
and like, if you don't know, it sounds aggressive, but he's just playing.
That's the end of your basketballs.
Look. Oh no, I like them, but they're a bit aggressive.
They're not barking.
I'm a bit scared. Because I wanted to find this of them, but they just, it scares me because they get really excited.
Yeah,
they're... Do you like...
excitable. I'm a little bit not sure.
Same.
I just think for what they want to do, like, you're not going to find another dog that's going to be sort of wanting to go swimming and boating. Like, I think they're going to be able to give them that sort of lifestyle.
Oh my god, I don't know.
They're pretty cool, Jess.
I love them though. I'm not sure.
No, well, I want you to be sure. It's got to be the right fit, babe. It's got to be the right...
Excited now.
But I think this really does come down to making Jasmine happy, but also know that these dogs are really good.
Pippi, are you okay?
I like being an only child because if someone goes into my toy room and touches like a doll's hair or something and it messes it up, my brain will like explode out of my head. Look at your floppy tongue. Look at your floppy tongue. If something's not perfect or something's not like in its place, it's just not right. Choco boy, choco boy.
I think the other thing is too, but Louie and Pippi, as active they have been, checking in with the family and actually sitting there. We do see other dogs not even approach the family.
Exactly.
It takes quite a long time, but these guys just go straight up. So you know, when they do calm down, they will come up and snuggle with you.
I just don't know.
No, you're not quite what you thought. No.
I'm getting closer and closer and saying yes, but then there's things that's making me say no.
That's your call, but I think they'll settle down.
They are really 50-50. They're just unsure about that play style. We can obviously help and educate as well.
Yeah.
Hello.
How are we going?
Good.
Just watching the crazies. It's very hard. You do your to and fro a lot in the whole decision making.
and want to know that when you say yes, that's yes.
So do we want to go for a walk?
Yeah. My mind is going to yes, but then it's going, oh no, but then yes, but then no. I don't really know. It's just so, like, hard.
Justin, being a bit younger, you're not as confident around dogs just yet?
If she gave him a bit of time, I think it'd help build her confidence a bit.
I think I'm going to say yes. I was scared at first.
They'll settle down.
They're happy to walk, though, aren't they? Like, yeah.
I think they'll go with what Jasmine wants.
Yeah.
And if she doesn't want them, they won't take them.
God. I don't know.
Bonnie walked in. She looked like a squirrel that was lost.
We freaked out. We were like, how is this dog real? It was really good to meet Bonnie. It was a reality check.
Yeah.
Yeah. And we decided to take her.
Good girl. Come here.
Good girl.
Hi.
A few outfits for Bonnie. Her favorite one, it's a pink turtleneck that is leopard print. It suits her personality, you know, she's a sassy gal and she needs a jumper to match.
Who is this beautiful new baby? She's so adorable.
Thank you. This is our child now. She'll take a double black.
Yeah.
We like to give her nicknames.
Yes.
Bonita, Bonathan,
Bontholomew,
Bonstance.
Yes.
Dog in our lives now has fulfilled our lives.
Wildest hopes and dreams.
She's honestly like the perfect little thing. We're vibing, so like, what could you ask for?
Yeah.
Good vibes, good vibes.
Oh, look at that. Money shot. My first impressions of meeting Pippi and Louie, I was like very nervous because when they came running in and they got let off the leash, they were very crazy and I was a bit scared.
But then once they calmed down, I realised that they were quite affectionate.
I thought they were pretty cool and I thought they'd fit in.
It was ultimately all of our decision. We did all have a family chat about it.
We were so torn if we said no, but then we were like, oh, they're the right ones for us if we said yes.
So as you can see, our update is we have Pixie. She's very much fit into our family and she's very lovable.
I hope Pippi and Louie got a good home, maybe with a big yard where they can really run.
When I first met Oreo in the meeting pen, he was not really drawn to me. Then he snapped and almost bit my finger off. So I had my doubts. There was only one way to find out, by bringing Oreo home. Oreo is now Oscar.
Come on.
He didn't feel like Oreo. He felt more like Oscar.
Yes.
When I first got Oscar, he didn't have any training. I called him Pocket Rocket.
Meerkat!
Oscar is really, really smart dog. I think that's a beagle in him.
Stay. Okay. Good boy.
Oscar is definitely my child now. None of my dogs were ever allowed to sleep in my bed, but this one persisted and soldiered on until he got there. I get a little corner on my side of the bed.
You're gonna help me type some emails.
Bailey will definitely be happy that I found Oscar. And I won't be surprised if he picked Oscar for me. He is just perfect. You're so beautiful.
next time on The Doghouse. Brothers Alfonso and Lorenzo are in line for love.
I've waited till I've retired, and I've got the time now to put into an animal that needs love and attention.
Will timid Chihuahua Angel make the first move? And it's hard to tell who's more excited, the Harmy family or Tala the Grudel.